Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube. And in this video, I want to introduce you to the new row-level security editor. It's pretty nice. But I also want to talk about a scenario where you can't use dynamic row-level security. So what do you do? Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam this guy. All right, row-level security, got lots of videos. We even have a course on row-level security. If you wanna go and check out the course, head over to dynacube.com. All right, I was on the phone with someone recently and was like, Patrick, we don't have email address in our model, so we can't use dynamic row-level security, but we wanna give, you know, Patrick access to this and John Doe access to this and Adam access to this. And I was like, do you have any type of logical grouping in the data set? And they was like, sure. I'm like, well, this is pretty easy. Instead of dynamic, we would use static. Wait. So enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So let's say you have this data model, and in my data set, let's say I want to give Patrick access to United States and then John Doe access to everything else. How would I do that if this email address didn't exist? So what you would do is, let's go over here, let's click home. And then you see where it says manage roles. We're gonna click manage roles and look at this beauty. Look at it. Just take a second to just draw it in. It's beautiful. And so what you would do is you click new. Let's call this domestic. And we're gonna click the little check. And then we're gonna create another one. And we're gonna call this one international. Click the check. So what we're gonna do on domestic, we're gonna go down to sales territory. We're gonna click it and we're gonna choose add. Now what I like about this new editor is I can just choose country, says equal to United States. And if I switch to the DAX editor, it writes the code for me. I don't have to write DAX. I switch back, it's still there, click save. And then I'm gonna add another one, and I could have copied it, but what I'm gonna do is say country, guess what? Does not equal United States. Look at that. Click save. We can switch over to the DAX editor. Boom. Writes that code for me. And that's it. I click close. And now I have both of those roles created. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take country, make a table out of it. And then what I'm going to do is just add some measure. So we got total sales amount. So what we'll see is if we click on modeling and we choose view as roles, you'll see both of those. If I choose domestic, we should only see United States. And then if I switch it to international, we'll see all the other countries besides the United States. When I'm done, what I'm gonna do is save this, publish it to the service. And I have this workspace called RLS. Get that published up. And then I'm signed in as me, and I'm an administrator in this workspace. What I would do is I would go here and then I would go to security. So for international, it's John Doe. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose add, click save. Let's say Adam covers the domestic stuff. So we'll add Adam here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and sign in as John Doe. And then in that workspace, you can see because John Doe is only a viewer, you don't see the United States there. I'm suggesting that you come up with a more dynamic way. But if you don't have email address, this is an option for you, okay? So one more thing I wanna show you. If you're using this new editor, there's a comment in the description of the doc that says, if you're using username or user principal name, there's a limitation. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So let's say I create a new role. Let's call this one dynamic. And that's why I have the email address in my model. So if I go over to sales territory and I choose add and I say email address and I type in user principal name and I click save, what do you think is gonna appear in the DAX editor? So if I switch to the DAX editor, it puts the double equals and it wraps the user principal name like it's a literal, and that's not what we want. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete this, click save. And so what you need to do is when you create that new role, switch over to the DAX editor and then type email address and then user principal name and then click save and everything will work. So if you're doing something that's really specific to DAX and you're using functions and things like that, you should switch to the DAX editor. If it's just simple filters against a particular column and you're hard coding the string value, you can use the new RLS graphical user interface to create your role as opposed to writing DAX. All right, what do you think? You got any questions, you got any comments? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.